All right, good morning, everyone. We are getting started. I see that some people are still joining us this morning. I just wanted to start by saying thank you so much for being here today. My name is Claudia Sanchez. I am the marketing coordinator over here at WorkTruck Solutions. Today we have the VP of Marketing, Joe Schneider, with us. Before we get started, I just want to go over some housekeeping rules. We do have a question box over in your control panel. Please feel free to ask questions at any time during the presentation. We will stop and answer them throughout. However, we'll also have a question and answer session at the very end. And today's session is also going to be recorded, so you will get a recording tomorrow and a follow-up email. And if you have to duck out early, we totally get it. You're busy. You'll get this recording, so don't worry about missing anything. But if you can stay the whole time, we would love to have you here. We're going to go over some really awesome information that I think that you will all really relate to and be able to use moving forward. All right, so let me just get organized here for a quick second. Looks like we have some more people coming on, so I'm just going to let them log in. Joe, did you want to say anything before we do some more introductions?
Let's see. I don't think so. We can wait till everyone gets going.
Sounds good. Oh, it looks like they are now logged in. So let's just go ahead and get started. So like I said, Joe is our VP of marketing and he comes to us with a tremendous amount of experience in digital media. He worked with Ziff Davis Publishing and SoftBank Expositions. And most recently, he was the head of internal user operations worldwide at Facebook. So we're very fortunate to have him on our team. I'm very fortunate to have him as my leader and I'm learning tons from him. Not only does he come from all of that background, but he also has a major passion for cars. Yep. And has a little bit of experience of working at a dealership too. So you want to tell the folks kind of about that?
Sure. So my dad was actually in the business back in the 80s, the early 80s, when I was, 16, 17 years old. He was the general sales manager at a few different dealerships in the Bay Area. There was Smythe Buick, Smythe European, Los Gatos Chrysler and Exotics. So because he worked at these dealerships, I had some sort of exposure to what that was like. And I actually, for a couple of summers, was something that back then they called a lot boy. So I would, go clean the cars with a power, remember that power washer, powering off the cars and getting them prepped for delivery. Or when we had new inventory come, I was the one that, would pull out all the protective papers and all that stuff. It was a thankless job. But I thought it was the coolest thing in the world because I got to work around cars. But yeah, I love cars. Always loved cars ever since I was a kid. I collect cars now. So it's a passion of mine. And to be able to be at this company, providing a service to an underserved group of people is hugely important. So I'm glad to be here and look forward to the conversation.
Awesome. So today we're going to talk about why it's so important to optimize your buyer's online experience, especially for commercial buyers. They're business folks, they don't have a lot of time, and they're searching on an as-need basis. So I'm going to go ahead, pass it off to you, and just let you dive on into it.
Yeah, sure. So, first of all, I just recently went and bought my wife a car. And, I know what that experience is. And as we all know, people today, when they're shopping for vehicles, they do it online. So we know how important our websites are and making sure our inventory is up there and as much information as possible. But the other thing that's different with commercial folks is the way they search for the vehicles. When I was buying my wife's car, there was a specific set of options I wanted, color, my wife wanted a certain color interior, so forth and so on. With commercial vehicles, it's a bit different. It's more technical. They're looking for very specific things. Not only are they looking for the technical specifications of the cab chassis, but also if they're looking for a job-ready vehicle, they're looking for very specific information about the truck body manufacturer, features, options, so forth and so on. Right. On the chassis, they care about things like cab to axle and all that stuff, which our folks here understand more than I do.
Right.
But that search behavior is very different. And if you want to optimize for a commercial buyer, making sure they can quickly find the inventory or the trucks that they need for their business, hugely important. And so one of the things to do is to make sure, obviously, you have all the details around the truck itself. That's fairly straightforward. I think one of the things that's harder to do is making sure you have all the important information, quite honestly, as much information as possible about the truck body that's on a job-ready vehicle there, so that when a buyer's looking through, they know what they're looking for. You know, right. Depending on what their vocation is, they have specific requirements. So they're going to be searching for those details. And then also how the trucks are priced, right? We just recently, one of our partners, NAPIDE, had a very specific rebate they were offering to dealers that were carrying low cab forward with their upfit on it. And you need to make sure that those sorts of rebates that come directly or passed directly from the truck body manufacturer are out there in front of that commercial buyer, because it's an incentive along with anything else. So those are the things I think at a high level that are really important to understand when you're when you're optimizing the online buyer experience for commercial buyers versus retail buyers.
Absolutely. And I'm actually going to go ahead and share my screen with everyone right now and just give you guys an example of what it's like to have an optimized experience for your buyer versus not necessarily having that. So I'm on a dealership's website right now. They're actually a lot further ahead than some other commercial dealerships who don't have any visibility on their site because they have a button that says work vehicles. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, click on the new work vehicles. I got there in two clicks. However, when I'm looking at their search options, I don't really have very many. I can't find a dump body. I can't find a service body. Even if I were to look like this, nothing comes up there. However, when I go to a different dealership site who has the same work trucks button, I'm taken here in one click. There's my service body that I'm looking for. And here are all of the vehicles that they have. Doesn't look...
The other thing I think that's important is on the left-hand side, all the different ways that you can go ahead and tailor your search. Again, it's from the commercial buyer perspective, right?
I mean, roof height, that can be huge for plumbers, for electricians. You know, they have a lot of crazy materials that they need to complete their vehicles. Absolutely. I mean, here's a dump body, perfect example. You have exactly what it is, Rugby dump body. You have the chassis information right there. And then if you scroll down, you can see all of the chassis information that's usually provided on a retail site. And then all of the body details, everything that you need, the body length, you know, how much can you tow with this? How much can you fit inside of it? This is huge for folks in the construction industry and landscaping. And then you have the price right here. You have the MSRP, the dealer discount. I mean,
you know, that's important because there are other pricing that you can do on the commercial side that you don't necessarily have to worry about on the retail side.
Absolutely.
You know, the other thing is vans are big right now. If you look at what's going on in the industry, that seems to be one of the more popular categories. We're just running data for commercial last year, looking at across all of our dealers and, vans are big. And one of the things with the on-lot photos is, you know, the beauty shots are great, but when you're a commercial buyer, you really want to go ahead and get some really close-up views of it. The reason I brought up vans is when you have an upfit on a van, you want to kick those doors open. You not only want to take that interior shot to show the upfit, but you also want to show the different, if there's some unique options on that upfit, it's an easy way to do it. Commercial buyers care about that. They're not the prettiest of photos. But they're certainly functional. And I think that's also key as well is, you know, as always the case, getting a real clear photo, very important. But on commercial, you want to focus on the functional features versus the classic, you know, beauty shot. So.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Good.
I'm going to go ahead and stop sharing that right now.
You know, the other thing is we're sitting here looking at this. If you're a commercial buyer, you know, in commercial, it's a long-term relationship.
Right.
Right. They typically don't have just one commercial vehicle. They might have several. And so giving them that really optimized, frictionless, I call it frictionless, but easy online buying experience when they come to your dealership, I think is hugely important because they'll remember that.
Absolutely.
You know, when you think about the classic things that we care about at retail dealers, CSI, sales satisfaction, sales survey index, SSI, those are really important. A little less so on the commercial side, although that's going to be changing soon.
Absolutely.
But making sure they have an awesome buying experience starting on your website is key. Because if you answer almost all their technical questions before they ever reach out, they're going to be more likely to reach out and contact you. You know, in general, out of 100 people that visit a commercial site, you know, you may get one person that reaches out. What we've noticed is when the buyer experience is optimized for commercial, it's easier for them to search for what they need. They get in front of the trucks they need to see quickly. all the information they need to make a buying decision and to contact the dealership. We actually see on average, you know, if you're optimized, you're going to get out of 100 people visiting your site, you're going to get 4 people contacting your dealership. That's pretty impressive. What I find even more interesting is when I look at the top 50th percentile of dealerships that are optimized for the commercial buyer experience, out of 100 people, some of, you know, on average, they're getting like 8 people contacting them.
Wow.
Those are big numbers.
Yeah.
And, you know, anytime you have an opportunity to get in front of someone and have a conversation about purchasing a commercial vehicle, that's an opportunity to generate revenue for your dealership. So it's really key and important. You know, absolutely. 80, 90% of people, they do their shopping online and they visit basically one dealership to go buy the vehicle.
Right.
So that still plays for commercial and it's still hugely important. So
absolutely. And then, you know, also having the right people that they contact and reach when they are ready to make that decision is hugely important.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
Retail folks are experts at a lot of those vehicles online. I know that they have to go through extensive training on all of the new vehicles and all mm-hmm. that good stuff, but it's no different with commercial. These guys are experts on their side of things, and there's functionality that you look at this vehicle and you have no idea that it's even, you know, capable of doing some of these things, but the commercial professional does know that, and they're, you know, they're experts.
Well, it's twofold, right?
Exactly.
So they have to be a product expert for mm-hmm. the brand that they're carrying at their dealership. Huge, obviously hugely important. But then you have different types of upfits.
Right.
Right. And those are made by 1-2 different brands that you might carry on your lot. And being an understanding the details on that off the top of your head can be challenging. Right. You and I have met people that can see a truck in a photo and immediately know exactly what body that is, who made it, what year, because mm-hmm. of the taillights over and so on. But it's nice to be able to answer all those questions up front so that you can start having that buying conversation right. When a commercial buyer reaches out to you, either sends an email or picks up a phone and gives you a call. So
absolutely.
Cool.
All right. Let's see. So I know we touched a little bit on long-term buyers. Mm-hmm.
Long-term relationships,
exactly. Yeah. Yeah. But what about those folks that, you know, maybe they're not ever been to your dealership before to purchase a vehicle, but you have your service department?
Well, yeah, so I think that's that kind of goes to the other half of the equation, which is about driving traffic to your site.
Absolutely.
And I think one of the things that's key there, you know, a couple of things. So first thing is, you need on a regular basis to be engaging with current and past customers of your dealership on the commercial side. So people that have purchased a commercial vehicle from you, or more than likely have brought their commercial vehicle in, they may not have purchased it from your dealership,
right.
but they're certainly getting service there. Case in point, we have a dealership down in Southern California. They sell trucks all up and down the West Coast.
Right.
It's not unusual for them to have a buyer buy at distance. Mm-hmm. They never actually physically see the truck, but they know exactly the truck has the outfit they want. They go ahead and come to terms. They actually buy a one-way plane ticket. They fly down. That dealership actually meets them at the airport with the truck. They sign the paperwork on the hood, and that person takes it away and drives back up the coast. Well, right. they're going to go to their local dealership and get it serviced. So it's always good to be in front of current and past customers who have purchased from your dealership or have had their commercial vehicle serviced at your dealership. It's also key to get your brand in front of them on a regular basis. Remember, mm-hmm. long-term relationship. 2-3 years from now, they may be buying another truck. They might be buying another vehicle for their business in 6 months.
Right.
So staying connected with your past and current customers, hugely important. Typically, you can do that with email marketing. We've done that for decades. Mm-hmm. It's very effective. We actually have a service that we do that to help our dealers out. But the other side of that is also social media. So everyone's talking about social media. There are a bunch of companies out there that will come in, and I'm sure dealers get contacted all the time. Hey, we'll come in and do your social media.
Right.
Well, let's talk a little bit about that. It is not hard to stand up a Facebook page
right.
for your dealership. You can even stand up a Facebook page for your commercial dealership or for your commercial operation if you wanted mm-hmm. to. And that's a good way to, one, stay connected with past and current customers. You just ask them to like your Facebook page. And when you have a new vehicle that you want to feature, you can go ahead and just go ahead and post it on your site.
Yep.
on your Facebook page. Mm-hmm. We actually just launched a feature with our service where dealers can now pick a truck out of inventory and with a click of a button post up to their commercial operation Facebook page. So really good to do that. The other thing that's hugely important when you have Facebook or Instagram, great tool for social media, it's very visual. You can also start running very targeted Facebook ads. Mm-hmm. And those Facebook ads, you can focus in on by vocation, job title, get very targeted with that advertising, and that allows you to maximize your digital marketing dollars.
Absolutely.
Right? You know, we know of a customer that we ran into that had spent a ton of money to have an external company come in and develop some beautifully laid out, nice, graphically designed email marketing material. Mm-hmm. And then when we looked at it, it was all broken. Yeah. It wouldn't have worked. It would have been a terrible experience. So there are a lot of people out there that say they can help you, but they charge you a ton of money. In that case, that person spent several thousand dollars, I'm not making this up, to have that one piece of marketing content put together, and it wasn't even done well.
Right.
Social media is the same way. You have companies out there saying, oh, I'll manage your social media page for you, your Facebook page for you, and they'll charge you several hundreds, if not thousands of dollars just to do that.
Right.
It's not that hard.
Right.
It really isn't, especially when you have something that's integrated where you can just pick something in inventory and upload it and just have it post. Awesome. And the ads, to do an ad on Facebook, it does take a bit of technical understanding. I know our customers and dealerships, they're busy selling vehicles.
Absolutely.
But I think the thing that's important there is understanding how to target by vocation.
Right.
You know, I've got a truck, I've got a van. This is perfect for a plumber or an electrician, what have you. Up here, we have a lot of farms around us. They're going to be looking for dump bodies and all sorts of stuff. You can go ahead and target right in.
Right.
And you can change it up. And the money you spend there, it's not that much. We had a dealer, we do this it's another service we provide, social media campaign management. And we had a dealer that spent, they spent $386, if I get that number right, and they sold two vehicles, right? And the nice thing is that service, that sort of advertising, creates a tremendous amount of data that, you know, our dealer success coaches do this.
Yeah.
They work with a dealership's marketing department and say, look, you're running a Facebook ad campaign. Not only can I tell you how many people opened it or visited your site, they can actually see that Facebook traffic that came to your website, to your commercial site, and tell you what it did while it was there. Mm-hmm. It's not just, oh yeah, I got X number, you know, I have to ask someone, how did you hear about me? And they tell you, oh, I heard about it on Facebook. Our DSCs are able to provide that data, that information back to the marketing departments and saying, look, you're running a case in point. We had a dealer that was spending a lot of money on Facebook ads, a lot of money. Yeah. Yet when I did the math, when I looked at the results, they could have taken $8,000 of $10,000 they spent that month and just thrown it out the window because it didn't generate any results for them. Because the way that the person they had doing the targeting, yes, they were running Facebook ads, but they really weren't generating the type of results we care about, which is someone calls you and says, I'm interested in the truck.
Absolutely.
Right? So...
yeah. Plus, you know, with using, since we're on Facebook as an example, you have complete control over all of it, which is so great.
Yeah.
I mean, you can put a cap on your spending. You can, you know, everything that's on there is your control. And although, of course, you always want to look professional on any channel that you're advertising your business on, it allows you to be a little more personable. You can speak in the language of whoever you're targeting.
Right.
Again, you guys are the experts. I know that most of you are a part of multiple associations for different vocations, and you know how they speak. I mean, you know, and plus with, you know, being able to price things correctly, you can also add conditional rebates that affect those specific folks and then target them.
You know, that's a good point. The other thing is, again, with the targeting you get on social media, you can actually target people that are part of a specific sort of trade association.
Right.
You can go target people that are part of a specific union you know would be interested in the types of vehicles on your lot. The other thing that comes to mind about generating quality traffic, you know, commercial buyer traffic to your commercial site is also what we're doing with body distributors. we have a new locator service that we're offering to body distributors. Everything okay?
We may have just lost the video.
Really? Can they hear us?
Oh, now it's back.
Okay, great.
We may have just had a technical difficulty. Sorry, folks, about that. If we lost you for a second there, we're still here.
Okay, good. Well, hopefully they heard us.
Yeah, I think
problem.
So.
So what I was saying is, you know, one of the things that we found to help drive quality traffic is the new locator service. We're going to be at NTEA. We're actually formally announcing this. We have a press conference there. We're going to be announcing it to the industry. Mm-hmm. So you're getting a preview of it here. But that service, you know, people have, just like they have loyalties for the type of truck they buy,
right,
they have loyalties around the brand of truck body they purchase.
Absolutely.
And so we found that people will go to distributor websites to actually look for a vehicle that has the type of truck body, work truck body on it that they need.
Right.
And we have a locator service now that actually will show them vehicles that they're searching for by body type, by manufacturer and specification and model, on our dealers' websites, and that has actually been generating a fair amount of traffic on its own, coming from distributor websites to the dealership's website, on top of everything else. And that's, wow, that's, again, when you're converting 100 people coming to your site and four of them are going to contact you, the more people you bring to your site from all sorts of different channels, quality traffic, the more people you're going to have an opportunity to sit in front of and sell a vehicle to. So it is somewhat of a complicated space, but I think if you break it down in its simplest terms, it's just getting focus and making sure you're spending your dollars correctly.
Right.
And you're able to get that buyer from front page of your commercial operation right to the truck that they're interested in with most all of their technical questions answered. And then they're reaching out to you and you're going to sell the truck.
Absolutely. Sorry, just had a pop-up go there. So on that, I know that you have a neighbor that is a farmer out here.
Yeah.
And his truck was getting old.
Yes.
However, instead of, you know, getting rid of his whole entire upfit vehicle, he just switched the body off. So
yeah,
it was hugely important for him to be able to find that chassis that he needed.
Right.
So, I mean, you know, it's just connecting the dots with our entire industry. And we really do have a complicated industry. I mean, however, when you think about it simplistically, we're all working together to make these gears work and run and ultimately get that end user everything that they need as quickly and as efficiently as possible. So,
you know, the way I look at it is this, you know, the commercial sales professionals, the commercial sales managers, those folks, they know how to sell, they know how to interact, they know how to work with their customers, their
right,
commercial business customers. It's that stuff underneath, that
right,
technical stuff underneath in the world we live in today. Social media, websites, getting traffic to your website. You know, I come from a world at Facebook. Oops, that's not going to sound good. At Facebook, and I come from tech.
Right.
And in tech, a lot of this is something that, you know, I'm used to and I can understand. But, you know, it's like talking to my dad, right? My dad's a professional salesperson, as there's the folks here. Right. And that's a skill and that's an
Absolutely.
Art. And it takes time and effort to be successful at that. So anything we can do to help the industry be successful, to simplify getting information to dealers, getting distributors and dealerships connected so they can service each other better, and ultimately so we can all service those commercial buyers, that's, I think, where the value add is. You know, advertising your truck up on a website somewhere on the internet, saying, hey, I have this commercial truck for sale, and it's up on a website displayed right next to your competitor or some other
right,
dealership, that's really not good. I think the industry is moving away from that,
mm-hmm,
moving these aggregation sites, and really people are now realizing that with the way technology is, the tools we have, social media, you can actually get better results when you have the right tools, the right services, and the right support.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind Absolutely. Of the way I think at it.
Yeah, totally agree with you.
Cool.
Did you have any other points that you wanted to cover before we open it up for questions?
You know, I'd love to get to questions, because this is where they ask great questions and I learn every time they ask a question. So I'd love to hear the questions.
All right, guys. So go ahead. Feel free to type in that question box. We'll get all of your questions answered. So just go at it. But I know that we did cover a lot of information. So if you guys have questions that come up later on after our webinar ends, I will be sending out a follow-up email tomorrow. So you can always shoot us an email from that. You can contact your dealer success coach. They're always loving to hear from you. So yeah, we'll open it up for questions.
Oh, you know what? Along those lines, that's a good point. You know, as often the case when I attend these webinars, you know, I watch it, I get some value out of it, and then it ends, and that's typically when I'm like, oh, I wish I had asked this question. So that's a good point. So yeah, if, for anyone who's currently a WorkTrick Solutions customer, they can reach out to their dealer success coach, and they'll be able to answer your question. If they can't, they can route it to us.
Yep.
Anyone who's not a WorkTrick Solutions customer, and we have a lot of you, I'm sure, who are on here that aren't, feel free to just go to our website, WorkTrickSolutions.com. And then click on any of the contact links. There's a bunch of them all over. And it'll send a simple email to us, info at WorkTrickSolutions.com is a good example of that. And just say, hey, I was on the most recent webinar, and I have this question. And that that question will find its way to Claudia and I, and then we will be sure to get back to you directly. It'll come from us. We're not going to send a salesperson to go answer your question, especially from this webinar. That's not our goal here. Our goal here is really to just kind of bring good content to you, good information, get good feedback and questions back from you. So that's why we do this. So don't worry. If you send us an email, you're not going to have a salesperson knocking on your door.
AJ says, always be closing, Joe. Thanks, AJ. And we're happy to have you on today. By the way, I emailed you, so check your email.
Just so everyone knows, AJ is, has been a customer of ours for a very long time. He's been an excellent partner, shared his knowledge, expertise, feedback, and that's really the type of relationship that we like to build with our customers, is very much a partnership. We learn from our customers. This industry is evolving and changing, and you guys are the experts. So we learn from you when you ask questions and interact with us. So thanks, AJ.
Oh, goodness, AJ, you crack me up. I do have a question that I wanted to get answered in front of some folks. I hear this question asked all of the time. We already touched on how you can increase traffic to your site. But when you get the traffic there, how do you convert that traffic into, you know, a lead or having them actually contact you?
Well, so that builds on everything we've been talking about this whole time. There are a couple of ways to get people there, right? To get people in front of you. One is they're going to pick up the phone and they're going to call the dealership. And you want to make sure that call gets to your team in your commercial operations, right? So you don't want to go to the main number and then they maybe send you to the wrong person.
Right.
Dealerships kind of have that solved. I know we provide specific numbers for our dealers so that it's a number that goes to the people they want. We actually offer a service that actually, if it doesn't pick up on the main line, it'll roll to whoever you want it to. It can roll to your cell phone as
like
a commercial.
Like a round robin, basically.
Exactly. Yeah. It'll find someone in the commercial department who can answer that call so you don't lose it. The other thing is, when people are on that vehicle page and they're looking at the truck and they're interested, you have to make it really easy for them to reach out. Some websites will ask people to fill out a form.
Right.
And that will slow people down. But keep the information pertinent, have them reach out and contact you and ask the question and have a way to get back with them. Either they'll give you their phone number, they'll give you their email, something like that. But the conversion happens with the experience on the site,
right?
And that translates into, you know, sales satisfaction,
right?
That's a major part of the experience, and you want to make sure that you're optimized for that. So,
absolutely. And for those of you who are using our service, maybe for those of you who aren't, we actually have developed a tool where, you know, you get someone on the phone, they're asking you about a vehicle. If you're on your site already, or sit down, log in real quick, all you have to do is keep on the phone with that person, get their information, find that vehicle that they're talking about. All of the vehicle details are right there for you. So any questions that they might have, you have all that information there. You don't have to go walk your lot and find it. It's right there. We also have the ability to upload your body invoices. So if they had really specific needs for a body, We display a lot of those details on our dealer sites. However, there's probably some details that might be in the nitty gritty that someone might really be needing. And all of that is also on the back end of their site. So,
you know, it reminds me of something. So remember I mentioned I, years ago, I was a lot boy.
Yes.
One of the responsibilities of a lot boy is to sometimes execute a dealer trade. And mm-hmm. I can literally remember my dad handing me the keys to a brand new, it was a Volvo, brand new Volvo. Here's a check. Go drive up to San Rafael to this dealership, ask for this sales manager. You're going to give him the check and the keys. He's going to give you keys to another car, and I want you to bring that car back.
Mm-hmm.
But the other thing I can remember, because I was there in the summers, I'd worked there, you know, my dad or someone on his team would be on the phone looking for a vehicle that someone wanted. And that oftentimes could take a few hours, because remember, this is back before the internet. Mm-hmm. But even with the internet, sometimes you don't know if a vehicle's up for trade or not.
Absolutely.
But if you can have the ability to look for a specific commercial vehicle with a specific type of upfit, especially, and you can look a city away, a state away, or across the country and see vehicles that are available for trade, and then immediately reach out to that dealership, you actually can keep that person probably on the phone, search for it, maybe put them on hold for a second, or maybe say, I'll call you back because they're busy, but you call them back in 20 minutes because you can reach out to that dealer, call them, say, hey, you have a truck. I want to buy it. Let's make a deal. And then you can put a deal together far faster than back in the old days when I was exposed to it.
So. Absolutely.
Cool.
All right. Well, I don't think we have any other questions. If you wanted to close out with anything, any statements before I go ahead and do some closing.
No, I would encourage anyone, if you have any questions, any sort of questions, either related to this webinar or just in general, we would love to hear from you. And if we don't have the answer, I've got a whole marketing research team. Seriously, that'll go find the answer. And then we have folks like AJ who will help us sometimes answer a question. So very cool.
Yeah. And last month I did announce that we were doing kind of a little bit of a contest. Mm-hmm. We are always looking to provide the best information, not only in these webinars, but in our video newsletters. So if you guys have questions that you need answered, big picture wise, or even very specific, or topics that you want to submit, please, please submit those to me. You can be in a drawing to win a free shirt if we use that topic at any point in the year. Again, we want to provide you guys with the information that you're curious about. So just let us know. There's no bad ideas. There's no bad questions. You know, we're all still learning. Also, Joe mentioned that we're going to be at NTEA. We're still giving away free passes. So if you would like those, I will include a button on the follow-up email that you can just click on, fill out that form, and get your free passes. And we really look forward to seeing you there. Keep your eyes peeled for our video newsletter from February. We have even more details about our new line of service for body manufacturers and distributors that I think you will all find very interesting. Thank you so much for being here today. We hope you enjoyed this live feed. It was our first time doing it, and we have had a lot of fun planning it. And we'll see you next time. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good day.